So it's Veterans Day, and I know I'm thankful for those who are serving our nation, those who are doing something selfless in order to truly foster change and make this world a better place. We live in interesting times, times when I think that this truth is totally lost. You got guys like Colin Kaepernick who protest the national anthem by kneeling on the sideline in order to bring about change. The problem is he's not really doing anything. Granted, I don't agree with kneeling during the national anthem. I believe it's a slap in the face to our veterans. But he has the right to do so. But isn't kneeling on the sideline usually something that you do when you've quit, you're done, you can't go on any longer? That's what it means to kneel to me. Besides, he didn't vote. Obviously, you can't be really serious about seeing change if you won't even do something as simple as vote. In fact, 50% of America didn't vote in this election this week. Nick Saban's another football guy who didn't vote. In fact, he said he had more important things to do. I guess that's what a lot of Alabama fans think, that Alabama football is bigger than life. But I've got news for you, in case you didn't know, it's not. Again, this is all an example of selfish ambition. The only change that these people are interested in is ones that serve their own interests, not the interest of others. Violent protests are occurring right now because people didn't get the change they wanted and the candidate that they supported lost. First of all, if you assume that all Trump supporters are hateful bigots, then you're a part of the real problem, showing that you are the actual one displaying hate. And I didn't even vote for the guy. But we all have to stop acting in selfish ignorance. Fellow Christians, this is not the time, nor is it ever, to selfishly serve your own interests. There should be no reason for tearing down the supporters of other candidates and issues or pridefully gloating in victory. There should be no reason why sarcastic memes and social media outbursts become what we want to communicate to the world. That doesn't show any real association with Jesus Christ, and I know for one, I don't want to be associated with that. We have to let love rule our hearts, the love of Christ. I am a Christian, I am a veteran, and I'm not doing these things to receive accolades. I'm these things because I want to see the world change, and I hope that you do too. I'm not doing these things because I want to win a social media argument, or I want to try to serve me, because I want to sit on the sideline. Anybody can do that. My dog does that every single day. I want to see the world change. I have the privilege of working side by side with so many that have given their lives to serving the interest of others. And one of my favorite verses of scripture that talks about serving is Galatians chapter 5 verse 13 says, "For you are called to freedom, brothers, only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another." I am a Christian and I do desire that everyone experience the love of Christ and the abundant life found in Him. And whether you already know Him or you're currently on a different path, can you at least agree that to see this world become a better place, it's not going to happen through hate or violent protest or running to a safe space or selfishly seeking personal entitlement? It's going to get better by looking after the interests of others, serving one another, loving one another. Jesus Christ in me helps me do this. No, I am not perfect, not at all, but He is. It brings me joy to serve through Him, and I know when I'm not pursuing the things of Him and I'm pursuing myself, I'm not really happy. But when I serve others, man, I find a lot of joy. So on this Veterans Day, may we take a clue from those who serve. Let's live for something much bigger than ourselves. Let's truly see the world change.